Hi, my name is Vlad.K, and here in this video I want to talk about maybe the fastest way of creating Neon from scratch, without applying any decent efforts. Here is what we are going to create in this video. We're gonna be creating this with Neon Lights plugin I've made. The main advantage of all this process is that you don't need to be a real pro in Photoshop to be able to do this. Just watch this video to the end, go to the website, buy this plugin, and you're all set. And I'll bet you create your neon sign like a pro. So let's get started. I'll skip the process of the plugin installation for both platforms because it's simple, you just need to run a regular PC or Mac installer and you're good to go. The installation process will be described in details in the supplied documentation, as well as the whole process I'll be talking about in this video. So after the installation, go to Window, Extensions, and activate Neon Lights plugin. Now you need to create a new document. We'll be using big dimensions and the resolution will be 72 pixels per inch. And if you're hesitating a bit about whether it supports 300 dpi or it is suitable for print, I'll say yes. And just show you how to convert it to 300 dpi in the end of the process. Now let's create some sample text. Go and grab the type tool. Then we set our text to 650 points and let's type in some word. For example, let's type the word love. Why not? Then with the help of the move tool, I place it to the center. Oh, just before we get started, you need to do an important thing. Go and hit Ctrl R or Command R if you're on a Mac and to show the rulers. Right click on the ruler and set rulers to pixels. In our panel, click on Get Started button. Let's do this. The next screen, we are choosing the mode of creating the effect. Make sure that the target layer is selected. Let's consider the first option, it's automation mode. Then click Next to create folder structure. Once the folder structure has been created, we are ready to edit the tube template for our future neon sign. Let's zoom it in a bit. The first tool is an eraser icon with a minus sign, that is erasing the tube parts from the image. Move over the lines to erase unnecessary parts. Select the second tool to add the tube lines back. Also, you have the history navigation buttons right on the panel. It's for your convenience. You can go back and forth through the history to redo or undo the result. Reset the result button can undo all the changes you've made. Okay, so let's break apart the tube. Now you're ready to proceed to the result. As you may know, some parts of a real neon tube are painted with the solid masking paint to block the light and break apart the single light line glass tube. That's what we're gonna be doing. We are going to add some mask tubes behind our main light tube. Go to the adjustment section, then select the tube edit and select back tube option. Start painting over the parts where you think should be the connection to imitate the look of the single continuous line. So you see, it looks like a single line. Letters V and E will be a second single line element, so you can see it reminds like it was created from a single piece of a tube. Like in the previous example, we have options to delete, add, undo, redo, and reset the result. Now it's time to add some additional clamp elements that will be holding our tubes mounted on the wall. Go ahead to the library section. Here we have elements that are the clamp elements and the holder elements. Let's click on the clamp. It appears in the center of the screen and now you can move it to the place. Make sure the auto select option is disabled. Your job like a designer will be to place elements to the positions where you think they should carry the letters. You can rotate elements by hitting Ctrl-T or Command-T on a Mac to rotate the elements to fit its natural position. Now in the same way, let's add holder elements. If you don't see the element after clicking, just move it around and you'll see it. This happens because the holder element goes behind the tube. As for the clamp element, you can rotate them as well. Now let's go to the Adjustments tab to see the settings. First, open the scene color. Here you can change the color for the whole scene. If you want to add more contrast to the scene, just select Scene Contrast setting. Manipulate the curved dots to add scene more contrast. Overlay effect consists only from one setting by now. Turn on Noise effect to add more realistic grainy look of the image that persists when you take photos on the camera. The Light effect section has different variations of light and shadow, so you can experiment with them depends on your scene light and contrast. The Background section is very straightforward. It has three settings: Scene Night Mode that adds or reduced light of the scene, Contrast and Vignette effect. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we are going to create this effect from scratch. Let's delete this example image, we no longer need it. We will be using this template I prepared, but the process is applicable for any other artwork you can create or find. First, make sure the template layer is selected. Then go to the panel and click Get Started. But for now, we are going to select Manual Tracing option. Click Next to create basic structure. Here we have all tools we need to trace the image manually. Here you can imitate the single line of the neon tube by tracing any image. It can be text, it can be photo, it can be anything else. In this mode you have more control under the process of creating. Let's consider each tool we have on the panel. Let's zoom in a bit to better see what's happening. I'll explain you all the tools on the example of the end letter. Select the pen tool from the panel. This is the main tool for the tracing. Click somewhere to create the first point. If you want to create a curved line, just hold down the mouse key, don't release it, and move it to see the handlebars. That's how to create the curved line. If you did a mistake like I am right now, go to the panel and click the undo as many times as you need. Continue drawing to match the shape form. To add more points, select Add Anchor Point tool from the panel. Click on the path to add more points. To delete points, click Delete Anchor Point tool. To manipulate point handlebars, choose Convert Point tool. Click on the point to collapse point handlebars. Click, hold and drag to create them again. Click and drag each handlebar to move them separately. Go and grab the path selection tool to move the entire path. With the help of the direct selection tool, you can move around path dots separately. After you have finished with one path, you can continue creating the next one. Go to the panel and click Next Path button. Now you are ready to draw the next one. Now we can test how it would look the line of our future neon tube. To do this, click Test Result. From our test, we can see that the loop looks not too smooth, so we can fix it. Click the Reset Result button, and now we can fix the path line. Get the tool suitable for your needs and fix the line. Then go and test result again. Much better now. I'll quickly add the rest of the lines to not go through every single line, and we'll switch right to the result. I've added all the past lines, so now we can test result. From the result, you can see that here we have connected lines, so we need to split them up, because in real life the tube cannot be welded like so. For this task we have two instruments that we have discussed in the first part of the current video. The first deletes the tube and the second adds it back. Hold down the left mouse button and move over parts you want to break apart. To add the tube back, select the tool with the plus sign. Okay, let's just skip it and move right to the result. So I have the lines disconnected now and we are ready to go to the next step. Let's play with the color settings now. Now I'll show you the manual way of manipulating the light of this scene, if you have it too many on it, or vice versa. Go to the Layers panel, find the folder with the name Neon Effect, click little triangle to open it, then choose Field Light, and then the Visible folder. Here you will see the three main layers that are responsible for the scene light. Select the first one. Then hit Ctrl-T or Command-T on a Mac to resize the area. While resizing, hold Alt key to constrain the proportions. Then reduce the opacity to for about 60%. Do the same for the other two layers. follow the video to do the same for the other two layers. Now we can draw the behind tube. Go to the tube edit section, then select connection tube option and start drawing lines behind to create effect of masked painted tube. The finishing step would be to add the clamp elements to the scene. The process of placing elements is the same as was discussed in the first part of the current movie. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please comment down below under the video. Feel free to subscribe if you want to see my other products in the future. Bye! See you later in the next videos.